Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chonzo. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 23rd of February. Indian climate activist Disha Ravi granted bail in Farmers Protest Toolkit case. Afghan peace talks resume in Doha amid concerns over rising violence. And Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan embarks on maiden visit to Sri Lanka. And now for all the details. Stating that the budget allocated to health sector in this financial year has been unprecedented and has indicated the commitment of his government to provide healthcare to all countrymen, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday said that the COVID-19 pandemic has taught us a lesson to be prepared to fight similar challenges in the future. He said the world is looking up to India's health sector, especially after COVID. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday said the world has noted the strength shown by India's health sector during the coronavirus pandemic, asserting that respect for the country's health care had gone up. Addressing a webinar on effective implementation of budget provisions in the health sector, the Prime Minister said his government in the budget has provided an opportunity to develop an ecosystem to strengthen better health services to handle any such future pandemic.
Corona ke dauran भारत के हेल्थ सेक्टर ने जो मजबूती दिखाई है, अपने जिस अनुभव और अपनी शक्ति का प्रदर्शन किया है, उसे दुनिया ने बहुत बारीकी से नोट किया है। आज पूरे विश्व में भारत के हेल्थ सेक्टर की प्रतिष्ठा और भारत के हेल्थ सेक्टर पर भरोसा एक नए स्तर पर पहुंचा है। हमें इस भरोसे को ध्यान में रखते हुए भी अपनी तैयारियां करनी है।
India, the world's biggest overall vaccine producer, is making tens of thousands of free COVID-19 shots available to several countries under its vaccine friendship program. The foreign ministry said India looks to bolster its vaccine diplomacy. While second phase of COVID-19 vaccination is underway across India, some states have reported rise in coronavirus cases. In Western Amravati city, streets were largely deserted as week-long curfew has been imposed in the area from Monday. Maharashtra state has ordered fresh restrictions on people's movement and imposed night curfews in some cities, though not in the financial capital, Mumbai. In recent days, 75% of India's new cases have been reported from the southern state of Kerala and western Maharashtra state. Meanwhile, India's total tally of COVID-19 cases rose to 11,016,434 on Tuesday, while the recoveries have surpassed 1.07 million.
A New Delhi court on Tuesday granted bail to 22-year-old Indian climate activist Disha Ravi in the Farmers Protest Toolkit case. She was arrested on February 13 for allegedly creating and sharing a toolkit, an online document that police said was used to foment violence during a mass protest by farmers in Delhi last month.
22-year-old Indian climate activist Disha Ravi was on Tuesday granted bail by a Delhi court in the Farmers' Protest Toolkit case. She was arrested on February 13 on charges of sedition for her alleged role in the creation of an online toolkit backing the ongoing farmers' protest against new farm laws. Additional session judge Dharmender Rana stated that considering the scanty and sketchy investigation, the court does not find any palpable reason to breach the rule of bail for a 22-year-old girl who has absolutely no criminal antecedents. The police had alleged the toolkit, which was also tweeted and later deleted by Swedish climate activist Greta Thunberg, was used to foment violence during a mass protest by farmers in New Delhi, coinciding with India's Republic Day, when a section of farmers also stormed the iconic Red Fort on January 26. Senior lawyers, opposition leaders and activists have criticized the sedition case against Ravi, disputing the allegation by police that the document in question incited violence. Meanwhile, a deadlock continues to persist as the government has refused to repeal the three contentious farm laws, a key demand of farmers who have camped at Delhi's borders since November last year.
Moving on, after over a month-long break, chief negotiators of Taliban and the Afghan government met in Doha on Monday evening and agreed to continue to work on an agenda to kickstart intra-Afghan talks. This comes as the United Nations has raised concerns over alarming numbers of civilian casualties in violence in Afghanistan, despite efforts for peace.
After being stalled for nearly 36 days, a meeting was held between heads and some members of the negotiating teams of Taliban and the Afghan government in Doha on Monday evening. Taliban spokesperson Dr. Mohammad Naeem has confirmed. Taking to Twitter, Naeem informed the meeting emphasized the need to continue negotiations and assigned groups to set the agenda to continue their meetings on the subject. Meanwhile, the United Nations on Tuesday called for an immediate ceasefire as it raised concerns over a sharp escalation in civilian casualties in Afghanistan, saying that the country remains among the deadliest places in the world to be a civilian. In its annual report, the United Nations Assistance Mission in Afghanistan recorded civilian casualties were 8,820 in the year 2020. Since the peace talks resumed last year, the majority of them were ascribed to non-government actors, predominantly the insurgent Taliban, and more than one-fifth were attributed to government forces. The Taliban issued a response critical of the report, saying the concerns, precise information and accurate details that were shared by the group were not taken into account.
Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan embarks on a two-day official visit to Sri Lanka on Tuesday upon the invitation of his Sri Lankan counterpart Mahinda Rajapaksa. This will be Khan's first visit to the island nation after assuming office. Khan is accompanied by a high-level delegation, including members of the cabinet and senior officials. To exchange views on regional and international issues, he will hold talks with Sri Lankan President Gotabaya Rajapaksa as well as Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa. The visit will comprise high-level talks in which leaders of both countries are expected to discuss ways to promote bilateral cooperation in myriad fields including trade, investment, health, education, agriculture, science and technology. A number of MOUs to enhance bilateral cooperation is expected to be signed during the visit. Scores of teachers in Pakistan-administered Kashmir held a massive protest gathering recently to demand for a salary hike. They blame authorities in the illegally occupied region of discrimination and ignoring their demands at the behest of Islamabad.
Hundreds of teachers who have been protesting over their demand for a salary hike for the last 1 week have intensified their protest in Muzaffarabad city of Pakistan-administered Kashmir. They blamed the Stooge government in the illegally occupied region works at the behest of Islamabad and discriminates against the people in Pakistan-administered Kashmir, threatening to blockade roads and highways and boycott all government duties assigned to them, including election work. The protesting teachers urged the government to immediately fulfill their demand of upgradation of pay scales.
हम सिर्फ स्कूल नहीं बंद करेंगे सिर्फ तदरीसी बायकॉट नहीं करेंगे बल्कि जब हम निकल आएंगे तो ये सड़कें ब्लॉक हो जाएंगी सड़कें बंद हो जाएंगी फिर हुकूमत के लिए भागने का कोई रास्ता नहीं होगा असातिज़ा की से ये गुजारिश करता हूँ कि आज के इस जलसे के बाद कोई भी हुकूमती ड्यूटी आती है बोर्ड की ड्यूटी आती है इलेक्शन की ड्यूटी आती है उससे बायकॉट किया जाए
Locals and government workers in Pakistan-administered Kashmir have to often hit these streets to demand even their basic rights. People working in different government departments accuse that their long-due salary hike and promotions have met a bureaucratic blockade at the behest of the political leadership of Pakistan.
Police in Pakistan's largest city, Karachi, are deploying an armed rollerblading unit to curb theft and harassment on its teeming streets. The 20-member unit, clad in black, are undergoing rigorous training and are expected to begin officially next month. For now, they have also begun practicing patrolling Karachi's bustling beachfront.
A group of police officers in Pakistan's largest city of Karachi carefully balance on roller blades at a training center and then leap over a set of stairs. It's all part of rigorous training for a new armed rollerblading unit, which has been taking place for over a month with the aim of curbing theft and harassment on the city's streets. They would be sent to public places with a higher incidence of theft and harassment, as they could not be deployed across many parts of Karachi due to the poor road conditions and uneven footpaths.
फिलहाल तो ये स्टार्टिंग है और मुझे लगता है कि फ्यूचर में हमें इससे जुर्म पे बहुत रोकथाम कर सकते हैं हम लोग और इससे हमें बहुत फ़ायदा होगा जैसे जिन छोटी छोटी गलियों में हम लोग नहीं पहुंच सकते हैं स्केट्स के थ्रू हम लोग वहां पर जाके जुर्म की रोकथाम कर सकते हैं और वक्त से पहले वहां पर पहुंच सकते हैं
The unit would also carry handguns, reducing the risk of bullets ricocheting, and in some locations such as shopping malls, the officers will not be armed.
हमें ये फील हुआ कि कराची में स्ट्रीट क्राइम की वारदातें रोकने के लिए वी नीड टू कम अप विथ सम इनोवेटिव अप्रोच हमने एनालाइज किया हमने ये देखा कि कुछ स्पॉट्स हैं जहाँ पर ज़्यादा इंसिडेंट्स होते हैं से फॉर एग्जांपल मोबाइल स्नैचिंग के तो और दूसरा ये कि हमने ये भी देखा कि अक्सर मोटरसाइकिल्स पे होते हैं लोग जो कि जिनके लिए भागना आसान होता है मोबाइल व्हीकल पर जो टीम होती है उसके लिए एट टाइम्स उनको चेस करना थोड़ा डिफिकल्ट होता है
The roller blading police, which follow in the footsteps of similar units in Europe and elsewhere, are expected to begin officially next month. And they have also begun practicing patrolling Karachi's bustling beachfront.
An Indian civil servant by profession, Rohit Mehra has opened world's first tree clinic and ambulance service for the treatment of trees and plants free of cost. The clinic in northern Punjab state aims to spread the message of conserving and planting more trees and plants.
A nature lover in India's northern Punjab state has come up with the world's first tree clinic and ambulance service for the treatment of trees and plants free of cost. Rohit Mehra, an Indian Revenue Service officer by profession, opened the Pushpa Tree and Plant Hospital and Dispensary in Amritsar City for the treatment of flora and spread the message of conserving and planting more trees and plants. According to Mehra, his team has assigned a toll-free number in which people can call and inform about their problems related to trees and plants, which is then analyzed by a team of experts, including botanists and scientists, who provide the cause and solution to the problem.
लोग हमें फ़ोन करते हैं पहले हम अपने उनको कहते हैं आप व्हाट्सएप पर हमें फ़ोटो भेजिए या डिटेल भेजिए और हम हमारे जो एक्सपर्ट हैं पीछे जो बैक हैंड टीम है जिसमें 10 से 12 बॉटनिस्ट हैं पीएयू के साइंटिस्ट हैं जीएनडीयू के साइंटिस्ट हैं कुछ ट्री लवर हैं जिनको ट्रेडिशनल नॉलेज है हम उनको डिटेल भेजते हैं तो वो उसका हमें प्लॉजिबल सोल्यूशन बताते हैं कॉजेज ऑफ डिजीज़ और प्लॉजिबल सोल्यूशन तो हम उस बेसिस पर जो तैयार किया हुआ है हमारी ये एम्बुलेंस जाती है उसी तरह की सेवा देती है
India is aiming to increase its forest area and green cover to a third of its total land area by 2030, up from about a quarter, as part of its commitment to reduce carbon emissions and meet pledges made under the Paris Climate Accord.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline. And follow us on Twitter at Asia Newsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.